Pierre. So I would like to share a few thoughts with you about writing a next server in Common Lisp. So for those of you who don't know what it is, the X server is the Windows system of Linux. I took this project on mainly as a learning exercise. So what I will only tell you about the thing that surprised me the most, which is code size. Let's put things in context. The well-known X server called X.org, which is found in every Linux distribution, started off in 1986 in at 15,000 lines of C. And now, more than 20 years later, it's up to 500,000. So then my X server has no features or stability or speed that you find in X.org, but it's only in return 5,500 lines of code. So, what happened here? Well done, this. But, so, two things here. I was using a better language, and also I am terrified of complexity. By that I mean, what happens when you have code, more code, and you have no idea what's going on, and just give up in disgust. So, what did I do to avoid that? I basically reorganized my program very aggressively at every step. So this is bad news. Bad news with this approach I took is that you don't feel like you're making much progress when your program stays at the 2,000-3,000 line mark as you keep adding features. The good news is that it feels good just after a while, not right away. And the Lisp is obviously the best language to work like this. So two things I'd like to talk about to support this. The first thing is macros. So I love Lisp macros. We've just heard the argument again that macros can be dangerous because a good piece of code should be understood without too much context. So I totally disagree with that, sorry. But everyone's got their opinions. And I think while solving a problem in the most elegant manner usually requires well-designed tools, and in this it will be often macros. And yeah, it's also important to impose a personal style. The other thing I realized is that APIs and libraries should be questioned in that, well, a lot of them are not that very well designed or designed for imperative programming and just don't work that well in a functional context. So then it's based on OpenGL, which is the most unlispy API you will meet. So what did I do after a while? I thought I'd create an intermediate API, which is a small one, which I call ZenGL. So what happened here? It kind of helped, but unfortunately, I don't think I've really succeeded in basically simplifying my program to the max. And I just found that it's a really hard problem to twist your APIs to fit your program. I'm interested in people's experience in that matter, and I'm still hoping to get to the right thing eventually. But I'm still sweating on this, and hope to hear from you. So, that's it.